let's look at the skill sets that are currently a prime on space station. We probably spend 80% of our time doing electrical and mechanical skill repair tasking. And we do this for maintenance, we do this for repairs, we do this when we set up a scientific equipment. It's some assembly required whenever we have new utilization, new science to do, and requires the same kind of skill set that is needed for doing maintenance or repair. So the number one skill sets that crews need on orbit involve using your hands to manipulate mechanical things, nuts and bolts, or dealing with wires and connectors and electrical components, possibly doing soldering, that kind of thing. If you look at our training, we get a minimum number of hours in these skills. For 2.5 years of training going into a space station mission, we get about 20 to 25 hours during that 2.5 year period on these kind of skills. And that training is mostly on non-functional mock-up equipment, not real equipment where you can't take it to an endpoint to see whether your repair actually worked. Did the wires you solder up, do they actually work? Does the electrical connector actually make a good connection and you get signals through it? We never take things clear to completion like that. We work on things in a clean workbench environment. And then you get on station and you find that you're working on real flight hardware, oftentimes for the first time, with skills that you haven't had a chance to highly hone. To improve on space station crew members' basic skill set, some crewmates and I got this idea where we could send people out to Ellington Field, where NASA has hangar facilities where T-38 aircraft are maintained. And we could do an immersion-style training where we work side-by-side with certified aviation mechanics and do actual hands-on, real work on airplanes, not just non-functioning mock-ups. And then when we get done repairing an airplane, because we're astronauts and we're trained to fly the airplanes, we get in the airplane we just repaired and take it out for a test flight. And this kind of skill training, where you would work out there for 2 or 3 weeks full time, could dramatically increase this skill set for mechanical and electrical training. And so we were able to get approval to take this concept forward. The mechanics out at Ellington Airfield were thrilled to be able to work side by side with astronauts. Basically, they had an astronaut for a lackey to help them do their maintenance, and it was a win-win situation for everybody. The astronauts get a big jump in their skill sets. They learn to work with tools on real working systems that they end up having to put their pound of flesh in and go flying with. And the mechanics get this feeling of working with flight crews, working with astronauts that are soon to be on space station, and it makes them feel all the more closer to the central role of what we do here at NASA, Johnson Space Center, which is human exploration of space. So this was a win-win situation for everybody. And now we've made this field maintenance training part of our astronaut training. And it's one of the more sought-after trainings for people in the astronaut office, because everybody wants to go out there and work on the jets now. This immersion-style training, which is now being done with field maintenance training, it's been done with field medical training. There are a number of immersion-type trainings that they subject the astronaut corps to. This has been codified. This has been shown to be beneficial. And it's just a question now of making sure that management condones this, encourages this kind of training, and reserves adequate budget so that this training can continue to happen. And maintaining the facilities, oftentimes facilities where you could do more than one kind of training. For example, the T-38s and the maintenance, we could do the field maintenance training when we fly in T-38s as crew. We can work together in a highly dynamic platform, which is similar to space flight. We could practice our crew resource management, our CRM, and it's a platform that can check a number of these critical skill sets that crews need when they fly into space. Working on the mock-ups is another example. Going off to medical field centers and initially working on animals and then eventually working on people is another good form of immersion training. If you're off in the wilderness, off in a frontier, you may not have a medical doctor. You may end up having to put a chest tube in one of your crewmates. And if you've never done that before, it's nice to have that skill set also developed. So the immersion style training for getting practical, hands-on skills developed, it's a way that transcends anything you could do by just reading a book and talking something over with an instructor.